Chapter 1. Aladdin and the Magic Soda Pop Bottle Lamp. What can I say? Years ago, I was infamous. The media gave me the nickname of the Big Bad Wolf when I was on trial for a triple homicide. I was falsely accused of murdering 3 pigs. My real name is Aladdin Todd Jackson, for your information. Every night, the news shows had guests arguing about my legal problems. A female TV host called me a wolf in sheep's clothing. I don't think so. I only wear Armani. Because I had money and looks, I was unfairly portrayed as a bad guy. The judge said he did not have enough evidence to convict me. The only evidence against me was a single note. It read, "I will huff and puff and blow your house down if you aren't my BBQ sandwich tomorrow." My lawyer presented receipts from the past 6 months. Did I do it? Of course not. My defense showed how I only eat at vegetarian restaurants, and an expert showed it wasn't my handwriting. As if I would eat a messy pulled pork sandwich. I eat at 5-star Italian restaurants, usually veggie pasta. Hold the Parmesan. I digress. With my name in the clear, I thought of several career moves. Originally, I thought I could become famous for being famous. A wolf's gotta earn a living. I released a song. I recorded my own version of Hungry Like the Wolf. It flopped because Justin Bieber had released his remake first, 6 months ago to be exact. Then, oh boy. I lost a movie audition because the movie director said, "You don't look enough like a wolf." "But I am a wolf," I argued. I flashed in my teeth as proof. He said I just had horrible dental work. The media followed me everywhere. I couldn't go eat a salad without being photographed. Cameras once swarmed me as I ate lunch at the Ivy. I couldn't buy wolf cleaning supplies anywhere. Do you know how humiliating it is getting caught in pajama pants printed with ice cream cones? Photographers hid behind bushes ready to snap photos of me should I eat a pig with one bite. Everything was blown out of proportion in the tabloids. When I had a bad meal, I told a rude waiter, "You're a pig." He sold the story to a reporter. The article said, "The big bad wolf hates pigs." No, I don't. I hate the men who act like pigs. Before long, a British tabloid accused me of wolfing down a pig in Essex. I couldn't escape the bad publicity. Was I really made for a career in entertainment? I had spent all my money on legal fees. I was desperate. Depressed, I spent my days being turned down at auditions, surfing, and shopping with the money I still had on Rodeo Drive until I paid my debts up to the ceiling. When debt collectors began harassing me after I quit paying my credit card bills, I opened my back teeth so wide he could see my uvula. It did the trick. One afternoon, I discovered a magic glowing soda bottle in a dark alley. I think it was Diet, maybe a Red Bull. I knew it was magic because when I kicked it with my shoes, a voice said, "Be careful." "Huh?" The voice told me, "Rub the bottle. I am a genie. I will grant you 3 wishes. I was confused, no, ill. First, I thought genies were trapped inside lamps. Also, I was hearing voices and seeing weird lights, which meant I ate too much ice cream. I wanted to walk away, but the voice said, "I can give you a career. I will give you a good reputation. Your wish is my command." How do I know you won't escape from the bottle and never help me? I've been burned by too many Hollywood agents. Your business deal seems weird. What's in it for you? How come you aren't in a lamp? A soda bottle's a little tacky. And on top of that, generic energy soda? Come on, I told him. The genie replied, "I am freed from my bottle when your 3rd wish is granted. My original lamp was sold at Sotheby's. Therefore, I was evicted into this giant orange soda bottle. Red Bull stuff. My name is Patrick." I asked the genie another question. "Patrick, aren't genies from Saudi Arabia?" Patrick explained, "Yeah, I am from Saudi Arabia. I changed my name when I moved to the United States in 1897. Stop wasting time. Either you rub my lamp for 3 wishes or you can go away." I rubbed the lamp. A cloud of purple smoke appeared, then whoosh. Patrick appeared beside me. "I wish I lived in New York City. I'm tired of my life in Hollywood. Give me a job as a news reporter. What's the name of the TV show in the morning? I want to work there," I told Patrick. Within a second, I coughed as the smoke transported me in front of an audience. "Welcome to the Big Bad Wolf Morning News Show," I said automatically. The audience cheered. Everything was perfect until I ate a slice of cake during the cooking segment. When I showed my teeth, the audience ran away, horrified I was a real wolf. "You're fired," a man told me. "Thanks a lot," I yelled. Patrick said, "You were not specific. You asked me to give you a job. Your wish must be precise. Do you want to marry a beautiful princess?" I was upset. I told him, "No, I am unemployed. I am a dumb wolf. Nobody likes me. I wish I was somewhere else." Oh no, I made a wish. When the purple smoke dissolved, I saw that I was a pink rabbit.
"Look at the baby bunny. She's dancing,"
a girl said. I was a ballerina. This was awful. I ran off the stage. When I looked in the mirror, I cried. A man told me,
"My dancers don't cry. You're fired."
I was a pink rabbit, and I was still hopelessly unemployed. In my reflection, I saw the genie behind me. I yelled,
"You are a horrible person. I did not mean what I said. Correct your mistake."
The genie made me a wolf again. "I wish I had money," I said. The genie escaped from his bottle. I thought he had left for good.
"There is a coin on the floor," Patrick said.
He picked up the penny.
"Here you go," he said.
"You can have the penny. You have money now. Well, it seems your three wishes were granted. I gave you a free fourth wish when you wanted to become a wolf again. Have a good day. I'm off to buy a hamburger. I'm starving."
I was alone. I did not have any money in my pocket. The genie was going to buy himself lunch. I could not afford to buy one potato. I didn't have any friends. My parents disowned me. Nobody spoke to me after I was accused of murder. I didn't have a place to live. I wish I had never met the genie. He made me believe in impossible dreams. The truth is, if it sounds too good to be true, it is. A quick fix doesn't exist. I walked into a restaurant.
"I need a job," I said. I had tears in my eyes.
"Then put on an apron and start scrubbing the dishes," the chef said.
Before you can say hired, I was once again, you guessed it, fired. I broke a plate with my claw.
"You're fired," the chef said.
I was getting fired everywhere. How was I going to make money? I needed a sign. Then I hit my head in a stop sign when I walked into it. Ouch.
"Are you okay? My name's Dahlia,"
a flamingo asked me. "I was fired 3 times today and a genie lied to me. I'm broke. I'm homeless. I have a bad reputation. People believe I murdered and ate 3 pigs. I'm a vegetarian. I cannot afford to eat," I screamed. Dahlia looked at me.
"You must have many talents. You should use your skills to make money," she told me.
She explained,
"I heard a legend about a magic place. Money trees grow in the soil. I was looking for the magic garden when I saw you. Do you want to join me?"
I asked Dahlia, "How do we get there without a map?" She told me,
"First, we need to buy a snack. You look hungry. Next, we will follow the yellow brick road to a magic cavern where you will need to say a secret password."
Dahlia bought me crackers, pretzels, and peanuts from a man in the street. They were delicious. As we walked, we saw a man accidentally spill yellow paint on a brick path. We walked 3 feet on the brick until we reached a cave in the middle of Manhattan. The entrance was sealed by a big boulder.
"The password is burrito," Dahlia said.
It didn't work.
"Open,"
she yelled. Nothing. I began choking on my pretzel sesame seeds as I wanted to tell her, but between coughs, all I could say was,
"Sesame."
I coughed about 5 seconds after it. Dahlia jumped in delight.
"We opened it. The password was wow, open sesame."
Inside the cave, we discovered an underground forest. Instead of leaves, dollar bills grew on the plants. We were now rich. "Now, what do I do?" I asked.
"We can buy pink shoes," she said.
I responded, "No, I hated being a pink ballerina rabbit." She did not get it. Dahlia gave me a strange look. "The genie made me into a rabbit," I told her. "Moving on. I want to have a job. Not enough shoes in the world will make me happy if I am unemployed." I didn't understand the concept of money.
"We will invest the money in the stock market," she told me.
I didn't understand what she was saying. Remember, I had to deal with a stupid trial for a crime I didn't commit for 3 years. I didn't have time to read the newspaper.
"We will read about important companies. Companies want everyone to participate in running their business. When you buy a stock, your opinion counts. You help the economy."
"I heard you, flamingo," I said as I growled at her.
But how do I make money?
When the company makes money, you own a small percentage of the company. You will make money when they earn it. We must read the newspaper to learn about successful industries. For example, if we see the prices of corn are soaring, we should invest in a company that produces corn. We will earn more money as the prices of corn increase and more people buy corn. Do you understand the idea? She said.
We pick the money fruit from trees in the secret garden. Next, we place the money in a bank account. Both Dolly and I researched news about famous companies. We invested in companies that deal with oil, computers, airplanes, and wheat. Soon, I began waking up early to watch the news about stock markets in Australia and Japan. When people heard about how much money I was earning in the stock market, people stopped me in the street for a conversation.
Can you help us too?
They asked. I did. I continue advising people on where to invest their money. It's my new job. I started my own financial advising business, and I love it. In a month, I was famous for positive reasons and ready for the next big chapter in my life.